Guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Ishpreet here. My name is Ishpreet. I am a mindset and manifestation coach. Today, I am going to be talking to you about what do you mean and what do you understand when you say that your destiny is pre-written versus you create your own destiny. What is the real truth? How does it really work? And what exactly should you believe? I'm going to share with you a few things that made me at least shift this entire focus towards my destiny is pre-written. Like I said, all the times that I have believed this or all the years that I've believed this, it used to make me feel like ki ab to ho chuka hai, ab to likh chuke hai, ab kya kar sakte hai, right? It makes you feel like you have no power over your life anymore, because if everything is pre-written anyway, then what's the point? What's the point of doing anything? And I talk a lot about manifestation. I talk a lot about how you manifest things in your life. So if everything is pre-written, then what's the point of manifesting? And what does it even mean? How do the two even meet and come along on the same page? And I think after a lot of research, after a lot of question answers to people and reading books and all of these has gotten me some perspective on it. So while they say that your destiny is pre-written, and while that may be true to a certain extent, it is not true that whatever your destiny has in for you, you cannot change it. That is absolutely not the case. If you go through different sort of negative situations and circumstances and you blame it on the destiny that, oh, meri to kismat mein ye likha tha, no, then that is not true and that is now not how it's supposed to be. You can alter your destiny at any point of time from anywhere, be it any situation. Your destiny does not control your life. It is not the benchmark and it is not the blueprint of your life. Because there is something that you need to know about our mind. You need to understand your own body first and your own mind first before you can go on believing these things that we've just been fed without having any background work or any substance behind it. Like, why do we even believe this? You need to understand how your mind works. See, our mind is divided into two different parts, all right? One is our conscious mind and one is our subconscious mind. Conscious is personal because you make the choices. Conscious is something that whatever you give, it'll take it. But subconscious, when something reaches your subconscious mind, it's going to be impersonal in the sense that whatever you give your subconscious mind, it is going to materialize that. How do we know that what reaches our subconscious mind and what doesn't? Whatever you feed your conscious mind through thoughts and through feelings. When you think of a thought, it's fine. But the second that you feel that thought, that feeling then goes into the subconscious mind. And the second the feeling goes into the subconscious mind, it will express itself in your reality always. Your feeling is the secret to everything. Your feeling is what regulates your life, controls your life, and whatever you experience in your life is only because of the feelings that your subconscious receives from your conscious mind. Every time you catch yourself thinking about a negative situation or thinking about a situation with a negative outcome, as long as you've chosen the thought and you can be aware of not feeling that thought through, you've just saved yourself. Because your life will always be regulated by the kind of thoughts that you're thinking and the kind of feelings that you're feeling along with it. You are creating your reality every single second by choosing the feelings that you want to feel. Like I said, your subconscious is very impersonal. Whatever feeling that you give it, be it true or be it false. I mean, it doesn't have to be your reality at the present moment. You could not be at a place where you don't want to be, but you can still have the feelings of that moment, or you can emit the feelings of that moment or indulge yourself into thinking and feeling all those things that you want to feel, and it will still express in your reality. That is the powerful part. You always have the choice to what feeling you want to feel. If you are consciously thinking about a situation, let's say you have a situation in your life right now and you have no idea about how is it going to go, just consciously choose the feelings of it not working out. You are consciously gonna feel all those things. Those feelings are gonna be transferred to your subconscious and your subconscious is gonna materialize it because it is impersonal. It will always express whatever feelings it receives. And on the contrary, if you choose to instead think about an outcome that works in your favor, think about how amazing it would feel if it actually went your way. How amazing would it feel if you just got everything that you wanted. That feeling is again gonna reach your subconscious and it will express itself in your reality. That is the biggest truth that you need to know, probably, that you are the conscious creator of your reality. Whatever that you want to be, whoever you want to be, you already are that person. It's only your lack of faith and belief in that particular idea that is not letting you see that reality. Make a conscious attempt and think about only the feelings that you want to feel and then see what happens. Your subconscious will always show and mirror the feelings that you have on the inside, and it will show it to you on the outside. And that is why nothing controls your life. Your destiny, your past, the things that you've done in the past, whatever you want to call it, nothing determines your life but your own self. You, your thoughts and your feelings. That is all that determines what your life is going to show up next. The biggest favor that you can do to yourself is learn to discipline your mind. For a person who has absolutely no control over how he's feeling, he's just led away by the external circumstances, external situations, and just gives in to those emotions and feelings, whatever's happening on the outside, that's what you start to feel every single time. He will always have negative outcomes in his life because he won't have control. You have full control in this moment in your life right now by choosing the feelings that you want to feel. No matter what your circumstances show right now, you can always choose a feeling that feels good. You can choose a feeling that matches the outcome that you want. If you can keep yourself at a place where you aren't bothered by what is happening on the outside because you know how to control yourself on the inside, you may see that, okay, the situation is probably not going my way as of the moment, but me feeling the thoughts and emotions of a positive outcome is eventually gonna express itself in your reality. You will always find yourself miserable, unhappy and depressed if you react to your outer circumstances. Your feelings govern your life. Your feelings will always be the indicator of what comes in your life next. You give it positive, it's going to show positive. You give it negative, it's going to give negative. If you think about it, it's really cool. It's really cool to think that you in this moment can steer the direction of your life wherever you want. And by doing what? By just consciously, I call it, you know, it's in a way, it's like isolating yourself and your mind, not yourself. It's like isolating your mind, zoning your mind out. It's like, forget whatever's happening on the outside. I know what I want on the inside and I know the emotion. I know the feeling of what I want. And that's like living in your head. And when you live in your head in that way, forget whatever is happening, your feeling will always be materialized. So stop giving into all these beliefs that your destiny is predetermined and all of that. No, you have complete power. Take it back. Take it back today. And that is all for today, guys. I hope you got something out of it. If this resonated with you, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I will see you in my next one. Bye.